Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it. What shall I say unto the Lord? All I have to say is thank you, Lord. What shall I say unto the Lord? All I have to say is thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have to say is thank you, Lord. What shall I say unto the Lord? All I have to say is thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have to say is thank you, Lord. I don't know how you feel when you suddenly open your eyes today and you discover today is 25th of March. 6 more days to go for the first quarter of this year to end. For every day God has faithfully been putting food on your table. For every day he ensures you have appetite to eat. Out of mercy, he sees to it that your body can digest the food and pass out the waste. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have to say is thank you, Lord. Since the beginning of this year, he kept your going out and your coming in. You travel by air, you travel by road, you travel on water, he kept you safe. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have to say is thank you, Lord. He has not allowed the devil to gain the upper hand over your life. Hence, you are still in the Lord. The devil has deceived many and taken them out of this way. But in mercy, he held you securely in his hand. He ensured that no force of darkness is able to pull you away. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have to say is thank you, Lord. Everlasting Redeemer, our Father, our God, our Maker, our Owner, our Husband, our Friend, our Supporter, our Backbone, our Provider, our Defender, our Hiding Place. How many are we going to count of your faithfulness? We say thank you, sir. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for what you have been doing in our lives. Thank you for that you are yet to do. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. If not for you, the enemy could have rejoiced over us. If not for you, some of us might be dead, buried, and forgotten. But for your sake, we are spared. Not because of our righteousness, but because of your loving kindness. Because of your mercy that endureth forever. We are grateful. We are not taking you for granted, Lord. For every blessing we have received from you, from the bottom of our heart this day, we say thank you, sir. Accept our thanks and praises in Jesus' name. Lord, here we are. basking in your glory because of what you have done and what you are doing. Jehovah God, one prayer we are praying today, anything we will do that will cause you to turn your back against us, take it far away from us in Jesus' name. Help us to know you more. Help us to love you more. Help us to serve you all the days of our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. As we go into your word, feed us again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Brethren, we should not be an ingrate, always asking and asking. Let's find time to always appreciate and appreciate and appreciate. I pray that our thanksgiving of today be accepted by the Almighty in Jesus' name. Today is Saturday, 25th of March. Our memory verse is taken from Hebrews chapter 5, verse 13. Hebrews 5:13. For everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. The topic says, are you growing? Before you answer, just this. Share the words together. You'll be able to conclude at the end of the message whether you are growing or not. Whether after you have accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you still remain at the level of a baby, or you are now an adult, a matured adult. Are you growing? The text is taken from Hebrews 5:11-14. Hebrews 5:11 to the end. Of whom we have many things to say. I believe you are reading it with me on the screen. Of whom we have many things to say and art to be uttered, seeing ye are dull of hearing. For when, for the time ye ought to be teachers, that is, by now you ought to be teachers, ye have need that one teach you again, which be the first principle of the oracles of God, and are become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat. Verse 13. For everyone that you set meek is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. 14, the last verse. But strong meat belongeth to them that are of full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. Even in the physical setting, you know, a baby that is born, when a baby is still a baby indeed, all you need to feed such baby with is milk. You can't make pap and give the child, except you want to kill the child. You can't take chicken and say, because I love my baby, baby, I want him or her also to take out of the chicken. You give a baby chicken, the baby will not be able to chew it and digest it. So babies are noted for milk. All they can take is milk. And the Bible is telling us here that when all we can take is spiritual milk of the word, we can't crack bones, we can't take hard teachings, then it's a signal that you are babies. The moment you talk about first fruits, some will not come to church again. Which one is this one? They'll be talking of tithe. They'll be talking of offering. Now another one is first. Which one is first fruit? Peradventure, some of you, my viewers, you've never given first fruit to God in life. It's a sign. You are still a spiritual baby. It doesn't matter how long you have been in the church. It doesn't matter the title you carry. If you still find it difficult to give your first fruit to the Almighty, and you are a spiritual babe. Some of us, we still struggle with the way we dress. Some of us, we still dress to kill and not to heal. On a daily basis, we kill people spiritually. Because men are moved by what they see, while women are moved by what they hear. A man may not have a single dime in his pocket if he can tell a girl, see, if you marry me, I will take you around the world. I will take you to Japan. I will take you to Holland. I will take you to US. The head will swell. Ah, finally, I've gotten the man that will carry my load. She will believe. But let a man be naked. It doesn't make any difference to a woman. She would rather say, what's wrong with this one? He must be out of his senses. He doesn't create any desire in her. But when a man sees an opposite sex, sees a woman, when a man sees what he ought not to be seeing outside, some sensation will begin. And he can begin to lust there and then. He can begin to make love there and then. So why do you find it difficult to imbibe the culture of holiness? To dress to cover your nakedness. You still need to talk and talk before you will wear a skirt that covers your lap. When you sit down, and maybe you have seen such baby Christians, when they go out, then they begin to pull down their skirt, as if that skirt will suddenly grow longer. They knew it was many when they wore it, but because they cannot take the bone for now, they can't crack bones. They felt, everybody is wearing it. Let me wear it. When you find it difficult to take the meat of the word, you find it difficult to crack the bones, then you're a spiritual baby and you need to grow. You can't afford to remain a baby forever. No mother, no father will be happy seeing a child of 3 years, 5 years, still behaving as if the child is 5 months. God will help us in Jesus' name. Attaining maturity in the kingdom of God is a process that occurs in stages. The first, which is babyhood. When a person becomes born again, he or she has to first learn the basic principle of life in Christ. Like we read, that they still need, if you go to Hebrews 6, verse 1, it says, therefore, leaving the principle of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on unto perfection. By the time you are a baby, you have to learn the principle of Christ. How do we speak as a child of God now? How do we dress as a child of now? A child of God now, what should be my reaction to things as a child of God now? What's the mode of worship that is acceptable to God now? You learn all those things. But after that, you begin to take deeper things. God will help us in Jesus' name. So believers at this stage are fed with milk of God's word. 1 Peter 2:2. They can't take the meat, talk less of the bones. All they need is the milk. 1 Peter 2, verse 2, it says, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. So it's the milk that will make you to grow. Then you will now, outgrown, taking up milk, you begin to eat beef. They cannot take anything hard because they are babies. They depend on others to simplify processes for them. Just like babies in the natural realm, other people must carry them and clean them up. All they do is eat, play, and sleep. If you are too dependent on others, you are most likely still in the babyhood stage spiritually, irrespective of your biological age. 2. If you are very selective of the word of God you read, believe, and practice, You are a baby. There are some of us, some part of the Bible, we believe it, some part of you, we don't believe it. No. The Christianity is not stupidity. My own Christianity is not to that level. Which one is your own? There is only one Christ. There is only one Bible. And the Bible, the entire Bible, is the Word of God. So when you are still finding it difficult to take some part of the Word of God, take, for instance, restitution. No. I've given my life to Christ. I've given my life to Christ. But, how do I say that? To go to so and so? No. To go and tell them, I've been stealing company's money before. You want to send me to jail? No, God understand. I've confessed to God and that settles it. It doesn't settle it. The Bible says you have to straighten the wrong you have done in the past. The moment Zacchaeus encountered Jesus, he told Jesus, I'm ready to restitute. Everyone I've cheated, everyone I've milked, I'm going to restore fourfold. All the company things you have taken without permission, you need to return them. When you don't believe that, when you don't practice that, then you are still a spiritual babe and not just strong in Christ. God will help us in Jesus' name. 3, if you are always complaining about other people, what they did and how they did it, you could just be a baby. It's well. The way the choir sang today, it's well. You need to see the way the usher dressed. It's well. In fact, the pastor, how he started preaching, the examples he gave, I know he must be talking about so and so. It's well. You are always complaining. You are always finding fault. This one is not right. That one is not right. This one is not right. It just is a sign that you are still a spiritual babe, a fault finder. So we need to watch it. If we begin to complain on everything, we need to grow up. Spiritual babies, that's point number 4 now about babies. Spiritual babies are so dependent on the prayer of others. When confronted by the storm of life, if instead of going on your knees to pray, you find yourself pursuing one pastor or prophet around to pray for you, it is because you need to grow up. They can't pray themselves. When they sneeze, hello, pastor. For 2 hours now, I've been sneezing. Mm-hmm. That's why the Bible says, when you are supposed to be teachers, that's it being taught. When you are supposed to be laying hands on the sick and they are receiving healings, you still want the pastor to come and pray for you. After many years in the Lord, it's simply because you refuse to grow. You are still a baby. You are depending on the prayer of others. You want to choose a life partner. You want somebody to come and tell you, hey, brother, hey, it is sister, see, God wants you to marry. What's wrong with you? If you're a child of God yourself and God is your father, you are the one who needs to go on your knees because it has to do with your future. That pastor you are trusting his judgment will not be in the house with you. It's not the one who wrote your destiny. The one who wrote your destiny knows the one he has planned to run your life with you. Spiritual babies depend on others. They want to start a business. It is whatever the pastor says. They themselves, they cannot pray and hear from the Spirit of God. We need to grow up. Some depend on prophets so much. I need to go and see that prophet. I need somebody to prophesy on me. What other prophecy do you need apart from what is written in the Word of God? Isaiah 3:10, say ye unto the righteous, it shall be well with him. When God has declared it shall be well with me, it definitely must be well as long as I live a righteous life. So I don't need to run after any prophet. Grow up. The question is, are you growing? Let's continue with our open heavens. Another level of maturity is adulthood. Christians in this stage are mature and no longer depend on meat, but eat strong meat. You know that kind of meat when you pull it like this. Hebrews 5:14 says this about them. But strong meat belongeth to them that are full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. One major difference between those in babyhood and those in the adulthood stage of maturity is their level of discernment. Those who are still spiritual babies, they can't discern good from bad. They are tossed to and fro. Hey, one preacher has come to town. They want to go there and hear what he will say. Tomorrow, one evangelist is preaching somewhere. They want, so they are going up and down because they can't discern. They don't know when a preacher is a false preacher. They don't know when a prophet, a so-called prophet, is a fake prophet. Because they are yet to grow to that level where they can commune with the Spirit of God and where they can know, oh, this is from God. No. This one is from the pit of hell. This one is heresy. Are you growing? Babies cannot discern anything. Anywhere people erect a signpost and call it a church, a babe will go there to worship. A church is church. That church is far away. There is another church close by. After all, they are calling the name of Jesus there. He or she will start going. Not weighing the word, the truth. This place they call a church, their teachings, are they based on the word of God or not? To him or her, every church is a church of God. On the other hand, adults are more discerning. They are able to test every spirit they come in contact with by comparing the character of such spirits with the Holy Scriptures. Mature Christian, when they get to a church, and they begin to see the way they are doing things. They look at the scriptures. Does it tally with the word of God? If, for instance, you get to a church where the prophet or the prophetess is telling you that your wife is a witch that is behind your troubles, you have to send her packing, divorce her. God cannot contradict himself. God said in Malachi, I hate putting away. God said in the book of Matthew, whatever has been joined together, let no man put asunder. So how can that God tell you to put away your wife? And we say, the man of God has said it. Which man of God? The prophet has prophesied it. It's baseless. Any teaching that cannot be supported with the word of God. So mature Christians, they compare the character of such spirits with the Holy Scriptures. Mature Christians also apply the fruit test. What do we mean by fruit test? Turn your Bibles to Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7, verse 15 to 23 quickly. Matthew 7. 15 to 23. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruit ye shall know them. Not every one that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works. 23, the last verse. And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you that walk iniquity. So, mature Christians, they want to look at the fruit you are bearing. You said you are a prophet of God. You have 3 wives. You say you are a pastor, an anointed of God. You are a divorcee. You divorce your first wife. You are married to the second wife. Ah, this is contrary to the word of God. This fruit you are bringing is not the fruit that the Bible made mention of. By their fruit ye shall know them. Mature Christians will look at the lifestyle of the so-called pastor or prophet or what have you and balance it with the word of God. An adult Christian is able to differentiate between good and evil. He or she can tell who is a servant of God and who is not. Can you call yourself an adult Christian? How sharp is your ability to discern? Are you able to discern between right and wrong? It is amazing that some Christians who claim to have been saved for several years still cannot discern between the true and false prophets. Are you fellowshipping with people you should not be fellowshipping with? Can you differentiate the Holy Spirit from unclean spirit at any point in time? Prayer point. We want to say, Father, grant me grace to grow to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Grant me grace to grow to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. My Father, my God, I want to thank you, I want to praise, I want to worship you. Thank you for the word of today. Accept my thanks in Jesus' name. Almighty God, please grant me grace to grow to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, make me spiritually sensitive. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, help me to be able to discern evil from good. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, we have been able to weigh ourselves on the balances of your word. Some of us have discovered we are still spiritual babies. We still complain on almost everything in the church. We still find some part of the scripture difficult to follow. Father, we pray today, cause us to grow in the name of Jesus. Cause us to grow to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ in Jesus' name. And to those of us, by the grace of God, who discover that we are growing, we could be called an adult, help us never to go back in the name of Jesus. Draw us closer to yourself on a daily basis. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Can we please sing?
Deeper, deeper in the love of Jesus. Yeah.
rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven.
Sing out.
Let it rain.